guys, welcome back. And today I wanted to quickly share with you guys my new portable washer and my miniature dryer, I guess. I live in an apartment, so going to the laundromat has been a pain in the butt, and I just didn't like doing that, especially since I am pregnant right now. I'm planning to do cloth diapering again. I did it with my first child, and so I really liked it. The only downfall was the whole washing, because we didn't have a washer or dryer at home. And so this time around, I got myself a little miniature washer and dryer, which is gonna make things a lot more easier. And I already love it. I've already used it a few times and I really like it. It washes the clothes really good. Obviously I can't put as much into it, but it's good enough. I don't let our clothes pile up like we used to. So once the baby gets here, I'll be able to throw a load in there of like the diapers or whatever, the wipes and everything. And especially because it kind of gives me the flexibility of washing my clothes at whatever time I want. I remember that when we had our first daughter, we would sometimes have to go at night, so like at 9 or 10 p.m. to go wash the diapers because she didn't have any more, and we were busy with work and school and church, so sometimes the timing was just not there. And this allows us to just wash the diapers whenever we need to at whatever time without having to go outside our home, especially right now with COVID and everything. So I really liked it. I'll show you guys bits and clips of how we used it, but basically it's really simple. I'll just show you guys. So this is our washer. As you can see, it has these three little knobs or whatever. So this one's for the washer, this is for the spinner, and then this one is to either change the washer's the washer from soft, like a soft wash, to a standard. I always leave it on standard, and then once we need to drain the water, we just switch it to drain, and then we switch it back, because otherwise if you try to fill it up and it's on drain, it's never gonna fill up. So yeah, for the washer, this is where the water goes. There's a hose that hooks up, but I just use a bucket to fill it up. It's just more convenient. I just use two buckets and then it fills it up. So the washer can go up to 15 minutes. If you wanted to wash longer, you just keep resetting it. So that's basically what it is. And then it goes down like a timer all the way till it stops. And then, like I said, that's the drain, that's standard wash. And then the spinner has up to 5 minutes. Now, what I've noticed is that when it has less clothes in here, obviously, a lot more clothes fitting to the washer than the spinner. So I usually have to do the spinner twice for every load, because otherwise this thing shakes like crazy. And even when it has like a decent load, I usually hold it down a little bit just because it does shake the first few seconds, and then it kind of gets the hang of it, and then it kind of stabilizes or whatever. Obviously, if you have it on the floor, there's no problem, but I have it set on this little bench or whatever. I have it on this bench that I got from Amazon as well, because it does have a hose in the back. So let me see if I can show you guys. It has this hose that I usually unhook and I pass it down the tub, and that's where the water drains. I even put a glove thing so it works as a filter. A lot of people are saying that it needs some kind of filter when the water is coming out into the tub, because it can clog it because of all the lint and stuff. Even though the washer does have a section for it to like catch the lint, and then you can take it off and take it out, but you still need it in the water when it drains. So that's what I ended up using, a hand glove thing, like the scrubbing ones that I got from the Dollar Tree, and then I just kind of like tied it up with a rubber band. And that's basically it. I got an extension cord that goes around and it's hooked up. And because of the drain, it has to go down. So if it's facing up, the water's not gonna get out, obviously. So it needed to go down. So I ended up finding this little bench that fits perfectly the height of the bathtub. So the drain just kind of goes down like it's supposed to. So, and it fits perfectly, the width and everything. So I really like it. I don't put that much soap inside of it. If you put too much soap, then it's gonna have too much bubbles and foam going on. So you're supposed to put the washer and then rinse it. Before you rinse it, you put it in the spinner and then put it back for the rinse.
But I don't always do that. Unless if I put too much soap, then I'll do that to get rid of the soap. But I typically just rinse the water, I mean, drain the water and then add clean water, and then that's pretty much it. I don't always do the whole spinner thing and then come, it's too much back and forth. So I usually just do it once I'm really done, and then after this, I take it to the dryer. It has buttons down here. If you push this button, it's for the heat, low and high. I always leave it on high because that's my preference. And then obviously it has all these degrees. I always go to the red one. That's what I use. I can also use the cooler ones. It lets you know which one's air, dry, hot, warm, cool. I always use the warm one. That's what I typically use. And then it does let out the warmish air here in the back. But like I said, but the hot air that brings out back there isn't really that hot at all. And so yeah. So that was basically my portable washer and the dryer. I'll put both links down below in case you guys are interested in purchasing them. I think it's a great investment just because, I mean, it depends on your little situation, but for us it's great. It's just us three, and my sister sometimes washes her uniform as well since my mom is not here right now. She's in Mexico, so we're really enjoying this little washer and things like that. So I get excited about things like this. I don't know. And I'll also put the link for the table down in the description box. And hopefully this was, what's it called? Helpful for you guys. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.